Hey, welcome to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about streaming and podcasting and working on Excel documents and creating internet videos and sitting on calls for work, for video, whatever you want to do. All of that involves one thing. I mean, you could say your computer, you could say a microphone, but I'm focusing specifically on the desk because recently, I wanted to upgrade my desk because I started looking around at my relatively small sit-to-stand desk where I wasn't using the stand part of it, and I didn't have enough room. I had equipment laying all over the place, it wasn't really organized, and I needed to do something about it. So I went on a search for the perfect desk for me, and here is what I found. So my biggest problem when I was trying to find a new desk was the fact that I have kind of an odd shaped space. I needed about 66 inches, so 72 was real big and would overhang, and anything else was going down into the 50 inch mark, which really wasn't much bigger than my old desk and left a lot of empty space. So after looking at literally dozens of desks and trying to figure out which one was best for me, I found a Porvata gaming desk. And what I loved about it was you could actually customize the size of it, the length, the width, and it was a fixed height, which is what I wanted. The sit to stand is nice for some people. I didn't get a lot of use out of it, especially since I have so much stuff on my desk. It really wasn't worth trying to hook everything in where I could raise and lower it. Now the Porvata, one other thing I liked about it was you can also customize things like the holes that are coming up through your desk, so you can feed wires underneath. You can tell them how many you want, where you want to place them. So it was a really good desk for me. Now, the time it takes to put a desk together can be an issue for some people, but this one was pretty simple. So what you're about to see here is a time lapse of the build. Now, it looks like I flew by, and of course it's time lapsed, but in real life, this only took 5 minutes and 45 seconds from start to finish. There were a couple legs you had to screw in, one crossbar, and that was about it. And the materials that came in the box were all set to go, and it was a really simple process. Now, just because I love time lapses, here is another one where I'm tearing down the old desk, putting in a new battery backup system, rerouting all my wires, and throwing on my monitor. So this desk was pretty much all ready for use. So once everything was put together, it was great to have all the items on my desk in place. And when you look at the quality of the desk, the wood was great. It's a manufactured wood, but really high quality, and everything was able to fit on the desktop itself. No more weird gaps, no more extra self-creations on the wall. I was able to fit everything I needed here on the desk, including my Shure SM7B microphone. I have an Apollo Twin USB audio device. I have my Elgato lighting systems, a SteelSeries gaming desk pad, and a cool little IKEA mug holder. And it all fit nicely, and it was great to have everything in a really organized, professional style setup. So I've been using the Porvata gaming desk for about a week now, and I absolutely love it. It's so great to have everything in one place on my desk, no more worrying about tripping over cables and having that giant mess underneath. There are a few things you want to make sure you look out for though. Make sure you find a good under desk manager. I actually tried out a couple different kinds and I settled on the steel case under desk management system. That was a pretty expensive one. It was about $90, but it really does a good job. It's a plastic piece that holds everything up underneath and you kind of wire things into. There are a lot of other systems that you can purchase through Amazon. It really depends kind of on your space. What you want to watch out for is see how wide you need it, see what kind of cables you're running, that kind of stuff. There's a lot of pre-work that needs to be done before you start installing these desks. So I also linked to another one I did purchase on Amazon that I liked, but it was just a little bit too wide. It was a cloth covered one by Vivo. So that's one thing that I really enjoyed was being able to clear up all those wires underneath the desk. As someone who gets a little OCD about that kind of stuff, it was really good to see. All right, so that's the Porvata gaming desk. Just a few other things to know. Number one, it's made in the USA, which I like, and it is custom built, so it'll take a day or two for them to put the order together and get all of the holes cut out in the right locations and the desk sized right, but it was shipped to my house in less than a week, so it's a really quick turnaround time. And in that time, you can make sure you order the wires, the cable management systems, and the surge protectors you'll need for your build. A handy little tip is to put together a document in OneNote or whatever else you want to use for your organization. Sketch out the wires and cables you're going to need, start measuring how long they're going to be, If you're ordering from Amazon, order a couple extra and return the ones you don't need, but just make sure you get everything so when that desk ships, you can put everything together and you're already set up and don't have to worry about ordering a wire and waiting two or three more days for it to ship to you. So that's our look at the gaming desk. Make sure you go ahead and check out one custom built for you because they come in different widths, different depths, different heights. If you want to go different colors, you can. If you want a sit or stand desk, they have those available as well. And so check it out. This was perfect for us. Go find one that's perfect for you. So until next time, we'll see you then. Which sounds a lot like, I'll see you there, or I'll see you on another time. Which, if you know that reference, reach out to me. Because we'll probably be best friends and go to Rush concerts. And if you know that reference, you'll understand what I'm talking about. And if not, Google it. I'll see you there, or I'll see you in another time. All right, I'm out.